There's a very interesting incident in the life of Srila Prabhupada. Once Prabhupada and his small group of devotees, they traveled from Australia to Fiji. This is in 1974. So one of the devotees who was serving Srila Prabhupada, he recalls, "When we arrived in Fiji, I remember it was practically 1 o'clock in the morning after flight from Australia." So past midnight, they have arrived. Of course, there was no temple then in Fiji. We were staying at one Indian family's house, and they had prepared prasadam for all of us at 1 a.m. So we took prasadam. Devotees had prasadam. Then we went to bed around 2:30 or 3 o'clock. Then, as Prabhupada did everywhere, when the sun was ready to come up, Prabhupada was ready for his morning walk, and that was always the case. It didn't matter how much Prabhupada was traveling, if he stayed in a place for 2 days or 2 weeks, as soon as Prabhupada got to the next place, he set his watch and set his body, and he just continued on. There was never any question of jet lag. The word didn't exist with Prabhupada. It wasn't something anyone talked about. Prabhupada never exhibited it. We went out on a morning walk, and he would walk as quickly as he did everywhere for about an hour to an hour and a half. Then we had a program. Prabhupada always had a morning program, and he spoke, and then we had prasadam. Then the two devotees who were with Prabhupada, one was a sannyasi, another was a grihastha. Then Paramahamsa and I, we were just waiting for the opportunity to sleep again. Very tired. Because we had only 3 hours of sleep. And for us, that was really difficult. And we were hoping after breakfast, Prabhupada would take a nap. So I brought Prabhupada his breakfast. And then when he was finished, I came and took everything out. And Prabhupada laid down. So I went back. I told, "Prabhupada is resting." So very happy. So Paramahamsa and I, we laid down. Of course, we fell asleep very soon, and we were completely knocked out. But after about 15 minutes, Prabhupada's bell rang. So finally, I heard the bell ringing. So I went into Prabhupada's room, and it happened a few times where I would literally try to wake up as I was offering obeisances and exercise my eyes so Prabhupada couldn't tell that I was sleeping. I sat up, and as soon as I sat up, he said, "Why are you sleeping?" Everyone is awake. The karmis are all at work. But see the devotees, they are sleeping. He said, "They are sleeping very soundly. Why are you sleeping?" And of course, when Prabhupada asked why you are doing something wrong, I never had a response, because whatever you said, he would just tear that apart. So I just said, "Prabhupada, I'm sorry." Then Prabhupada asked, "What about Paramahamsa Maharaj? Why is he sleeping? Call him in." He goes in, and immediately Prabhupada says, Paramahamsa Maharaj comes in, and then Prabhupada says, "You are a sannyasi. Your business is to minimize bodily demands, minimize sleeping, minimize eating. Why are you sleeping?" Paramahamsa said, "Prabhupada, I have jet lag." Oh my God, I thought, oh no. Prabhupada said, "Jet lag? So I am also flying. I am doing the same thing. I am awake." Then he said, like that he spoke a little bit. And then Prabhupada said, "All right, go on. Go and sleep if you want." So the idea is here, Prabhupada is talking that how we must minimize bodily demands. You see, the word initiation, the Sanskrit word for initiation is One of the words is Upanayana. That's there in the Vedic culture. The word Upanayana means, Upa means near, Nayana means to draw or to bring. Upanayana means the spiritual master brings the disciple closer, draws him closer. What does that mean, draws him closer, makes him sit next to him or something? No. The spiritual master is in a very elevated consciousness and he draws the disciple closer to him in his spiritual consciousness. That is the meaning. That is why Upanayana, initiation, is an event. It happens, a ceremony on which, you know, all the, we get the name and all of that. But it is also a process. It's an ongoing process of drawing the disciple closer, the spiritual master drawing the disciple closer and closer to him, in the sense of closer to his consciousness. And we see how Srila Prabhupada was in that elevated stage. He was not affected by the bodily demands. Just like here it is said, Siddho Navipashyati. What is happening? Deham Utstitam Uttitam Va. He's not affected by that. But the disciples maybe, because they are not in that stage. But he is encouraging them, drawing them closer. So you see the real spirit of the word Upanayanam, bringing a disciple closer, how Prabhupada is actually doing that. That was the spirit of Srila Prabhupada's conduct in all of his instructions. He was trying to help the disciples come to a higher state of consciousness.